Welcome to Lunapark Sydney's 2024 event for Lunapark in the Dark, which is running from May 24th all the way until June 9th. It's been quite a while since we've been back at Lunapark, and this is going to be obviously a different video. We're going to be having an explore around the park, and all tickets include little candlelight concerts, Sonic Neon, and also just some different kind of performances just throughout the night. And also a really nice dessert bar. I don't think we'll be getting any dessert, but we'll probably just be having a look and just seeing what they have. But as you can see, we already have a lovely entrance here with all the lights turned off, and it's all blue. Like, it's completely like so immersive inside with like smoke machines in the background. So we're gonna go in and have a look, and I'm gonna take you guys. So if you do want to visit Lunapark in the Dark, if you have an annual pass, a Lunapark Sydney annual pass, it's about $30. But if you don't have an annual pass and you want to buy a ticket, it starts from about $55. But I'm pretty sure the ticket price depends on what night you go. So it's a Saturday night for me right now. And again, it just depends on what night you go. Whatever, and we just made it in. I didn't need to ask them to like check. I had to check myself. I had to chip my water out in the drain from my water bottle, which makes absolutely no sense. I have no idea why they were doing that, because water is such a simple thing to get. But anyway, it smells really bad because of like the sewage system and also like the ocean's close by.
Here's a quick look at the Ferris wheel, which is going. And the carousel's looking nice too. And there's also some like entertainers like over there with like a rainbow like cool looking kind of thing.
But I think I'm gonna do hair raising next. I just saw it run, so I'll definitely be doing that first, because it'll just get really good views of the whole area. So I'm gonna go do that, and then after I think I'm gonna go check out Sonic Neon, because I haven't experienced that yet. And it just seems really cool. And also, Tango Train is under maintenance, in case you didn't know that already. Anyway, let's go to Hairraiser.
And Hairraiser is literally a walk-on right now. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and do that. And I will be doing Sonic Neon later. But we're walking through the queue, and this is actually the sickest queue ever with the lights off. There's like no lights on. Yeah!
Okay, so they in fact only needed one more person that was just there. So they just were able to let me on just like that. And yeah, honestly, I think that was one of my most, that was the ride that was the most forceful to me. I don't know why, that ride just really stuck out, just being all the way up there. And it was just incredibly forceful. We're now gonna go ahead and check out Sonic Neon, because it's literally right next to Hairraiser. And then after,
we might go to Sledgehammer. Maybe, I'm not sure, we'll see. Wow, look at this, guys. Oh my god.
This is really cool. Oh my god, look at this.
There's like a whole maze.
This is so trippy. Oh my god. Oh my god, where are we meant to go? Oh my god.
Ah, okay, we're meant to go through here. Oh, this is really cool.
This is sick. I love this, but I don't think it's definitely not worth like $25, but
this, guys, this looks insane, absolutely insane. Oh my god,
this is so tricky. I love this. This is incredible. Definitely quite loud in here. Make sure to experience actually continues upstairs. So we're gonna go and have a look what there is. And there is a black light dessert bar. So we'll go and have a look and see if there is any. This already does look really cool.
It's like all this and stuff. Oh yeah.
That is really sick actually, I do like that. Okay, I came to Sonic Neon, I didn't get any of the desserts, but I got the free water. It is so cold, and it is so good. Like, I'm actually so glad it's free and not like $5, which is the regular price for like water. Just like a regular bottle of water here at Luna Park is like $5. I paid nothing for this, and it's got ice in it. It is so cold, and it's so good. We're gonna go through the exit now. And that was our experience at Sonic Neon. And that was really sick. I actually really enjoyed that. Although it's definitely not worth the $25 though. But definitely Luna Park in the Dark is worth the $25. So. Okay, again, that experience at Sonic Neon was amazing. I really loved it. And now all we're gonna do is Big Dipper open. It is open, so we're gonna go and snag a quick ride on Big Dipper just because I'm sure it'll be like really sick like in the dark, and it will be really cool as well. So let's go ahead and ride Big Dipper.
I gotta admit, I do like love Big Dipper at night because it's just so vibey, and being the only Intamin single rail, it is just such a cool vibe here. It's really good for off rides because you get like to go on this like little bridge thing. You get some great shots of the ride here as it comes by. And it's running the red train at the moment, so let's go ahead and get a ride on Big Dipper. Oh my god, look at the drooling man with sledgehammer. Oh my god. No way. There goes the airtime pill. S-Band. There's the ball screen.
Alright, we just did Big Dipper, and I want to be honest with you, that was probably one of the smoothest rides I've had on that. It still is rough, but like, it was running the red train, and honestly, it's still rough, but I feel like it was smoother. It's so hard to tell, but I'm happy I did get a ride because it wasn't a walk-on, but I was able to walk on because I was a single rider, and they needed a single rider, so I was happy I was able to get a ride on that. It looks like Boomerang and Sledgehammer are operating, so I might do Sledgehammer now just because it has a long line. Like it normally has a long line. So let's go and do Sledgehammer. Okay, I just got a Sledgehammer, and honest thoughts, I hate the over the shoulder restraints, especially I'm over 6 foot now, and they really just dig into your shoulders. I really don't like them. But the funny thing is, when you ride it, and when the ride's over, they feel less restrictive as you're riding it, which is really strange. I don't know if I just get looser or something, or if it's just like an illusion that just like takes your mind off them when you're on the ride. It's honestly like a really strange thing, but we're gonna go ahead and I kind of want to do a little nipper. It's really fun. I wish I had my GoPro because I haven't done like an on-ride POV of Little Nipper really. And I'm going to do Boomerang as well, so yeah, it's actually not too busy today. Sledgehammer's probably the most busiest ride, so let's go do Boomerang. So I just rode Boomerang, and I felt like I didn't get as much force as I used to. I don't know whether I just keep forgetting what it feels like. You do get quite a bit of, like, ejector or like photo airtime out of like the first drop when you're going forwards, but I think honestly the best moment in the ride is when you're going backwards through the helix. That gives you some really good positives, and it just feels really just great too. And it actually just went past the helix. I'm currently trying to get an off ride of Sledgehammer because I don't have any like night off rides, so I'm just waiting for that, and then I don't know what I'm going to do next. I might either do something else or I'll probably just go home because I'm not really sure there's anything else to do that I will pick you up.
Alright, so that's going to wrap up our time here at Luna Park in the, at the Luna Park in the Dark event. I really hope you guys enjoyed that video, and if you do, make sure to like and subscribe because there'll be more vlogs coming of my theme park trips too. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video again. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next vlog. Bye!